It's all gone. I drank all of it. Hopefully, it will keep me awake for the rest of this video. I really hope so. Because it's currently 7:01 a.m. Oh, God. I just wanted to pop my back right there. Ooh, I could feel it too. Oh my God, I could feel that something in there. I'm having a brain fart. That's how tired I am right now. I know the word, but I'm so tired I can't think of the damn word. Kink. I could feel that kink in there. I don't know. Either way, let's just get on with the video so that way I can go to sleep. The fox and the wolf. Now, for you new subscribers, you guys might be wondering, what is the fox and the wolf? Well, quite simply, it is my first published book, and it certainly will not be the last. And basically, in this video, I'm going to be telling you guys, I got something wet on my head. Basically, I can't think of the word to basically describe what I want to say, but I'm just going to say it like this. The Fox and the Wolf is a romance fantasy novel. And this novel is based off of my relationship with my fiance. So basically, I'm going to tell you guys certain things that happen in this book that pretty much happened in real life. Now, I'm not going to say all of them simply because I don't want to spoil anything for people who are actually interested in reading this. And I'm going to try and be not as descriptive for people. So that way, it doesn't spoil anything still. But like I said, I'm not going to say all of them, but I'm also not going to be as descriptive. That way people can still like just guess at it, I guess you could say. So yeah, let's get on. Now, I don't have a list with me. And that's also another reason why I'm not going to list all of them. But The Fox and the Wolf definitely has a lot of similarities to our relationship. The first one being is the necklace. Now, if you guys have read the book, because I know some people have read the book who are watching my videos right now, the necklace, the feather necklace. Now, whew, I just realized. Oh, damn it. God damn it. Trying to think, trying to think, trying to think. I actually do want to show you. Fucking hell. Uno momento, por favor. Just keep that in mind. The necklace. Yeah. Yeah, I just unplugged my fucking laptop. Way to go, Justice! All right. So, if you guys have read the book, or if you haven't read the book, you're watching this anyway, so you know what I'm talking about anyways. So it's just about a necklace. The necklace is actually real, basically. That's the necklace that I was pretty much basing it off of. I wore that necklace a lot, and I had that necklace for a very long time since fifth grade. And it was basically a part of me, in short. So when my fiance, who was at the time my girlfriend, she, after 3 years, she was, I think it was 3 years. I have no idea. I think it definitely was 3 years. Her family and herself, oh, excuse me. Her family and herself decided to move up north to pretty much for, God, I'm so out of breath because I was trying to hurry up and find a picture. Anyways, her family and herself decided to move up north so that way she can go to college up there. And a lot of personal things were also going on, I'm not going to get into. So, as a gift, I basically gave her the necklace. So, that's pretty much where that comes from. It was such a big part of me, and this was a very big step in our relationship. You know, she was going to be in New York, I was going to be in Florida. So I wanted to give her something that was very special and dear to me. And she knew how much that was, like how she basically knew how much it meant to me to have it because she knew I wore it pretty much every single day. So the day I actually gave it to her, she looked at me and like she looked like she was gonna cry because she was just so in shock by it that I actually gave it to her. You know, I was dancing with her. We both were dressed really nice. We were dancing and I had her close her eyes. I grabbed a necklace out and just put it around her neck. She opens her eyes, looks at it, and just goes, looks at me like, "Really?" You know, it was just like, it was a really, really nice moment between us. And just so you guys know, it is a feather. So I did pretty much go into detail on how it was. And yes, my hair was blonde, so you guys can laugh all you fucking want. And if you guys are laughing, shut the fuck up. All right, so that is one thing. The other thing is the date. The date that Wolf and Vi pretty much meet each other is October 3rd, 1486. As you guys saw in one of my previous videos today, October 3rd, 2009 is the day me and Stacy pretty much started going out. So that's where that comes from. The other thing is, what are the other things that's happened? Oddly enough, it is very creepy how this happened. But the way me and her, I've told you guys a story on how me and her proposed, and the way a certain scene plays out on in The Fox and the Wolf is very creepily similar to that. It kind of felt like I was predicting the future. The lines Vi was saying was very similar to what Stacy said to me the day before I proposed to her. And the day after in The Fox and the Wolf, that's when, you know, Wolf gives her a present. So that's where I'm like, did I predict the future? Because like I said in my previous video, I never planned on the way I proposed to her. That all was just spur of the moment type of thing. So that's where I'm like, that's very creepy. It really was. And, all right, and since you guys know it's a romance, it's not really a spoiler, but there's also another scene where basically Vi and Wolf, they're having a little moment, and then Vi looks at him deep in his eyes and goes, "Can I have my kiss now?" Which in my previous video, I pretty much told you guys how me and her, our first kiss went, and she basically said it just like that. Can I have my kiss now? So that was, I've always wanted to put that in the book. That was one scene I really wanted in there where, you know, where basically she just said that. It didn't matter what the scene was, I just wanted her to say that. Another similarity would be there's basically a fight that goes between Fox, or not Fox. Whew, I'm so tired. Vi and Wolf. And the way that goes down is very similar to when I started doing YouTube. I was very passionate about it. And because of that, me and Stacy got in a fight, which made me stop doing YouTube for a while. Because I was just so passionate about it, and it just got really nasty. So I tried to bend it to where it fit the story, fit how the characters were, but that was basically the similarity there. There was also another similarity with the tent, which I will not get into because that definitely is not going to be said on this video. I'm sorry, I'm just really tired, and I know I keep repeating myself. I'm just telling myself that. There was also another scene where Vi is wearing a pink dress. Pretty much, she was wearing a pink dress, which don't think I can reach that just because my sleeves are so tight. Come here. There you go. But yeah, there was a scene where Vi was wearing a pink dress, and the way Vi and Wolf were acting with each other, was very similar to our prom night. So, yeah, that's pretty much where that similarity comes from. The back of that picture frame, did not like that feeling at all. That was a very weird feeling. Actually, you know what? I think I actually might be revealing to you guys every little detail that's similar to our relationship because I don't know if there's a lot more, but I think I'm naming all of them. So, there's also a scene where, Vi pretty much is pretty much there's a part where Vi picks up, yarn and all that basically. Yarn and just making things with yarn, that kind of thing. I hate it when I'm tired because I can't think of the fucking words. But that is very similar to something Stacy actually does. It's something Stacy actually does or has done in the past, which is cross-stitching, I think. It was basically like these wires that were connected with each other and they made a picture and she had to follow the rules and it basically made like these really amazing pictures of, say, like a white tiger or a husky. And that's basically where that idea came from. It's basically where that idea came from. Now, the book also takes place in a 3-month time span. Yeah, my mouth is getting really dry. But yeah, the book basically takes place during a 3-month time span. I feel like I'm saying spam. 3-month time span. You got it? Got it? All right, that really hurt. Oh. Anyways, the book pretty much takes place. The book pretty much takes place in a 3-month time. I'll just say time because I'm not saying span again. And as I said before, it pretty much was in our third year in our relationship where her and her family moved away. So that's where that came from. I just wanted the book to take place for those 3 months to kind of represent the 3 years me and her were together. Or that actually sounds really bad the way I said it. Like I said, I'm so tired. I think my mind is completely mush right now. Ugh, excuse me. But basically hate being tired. Oh, I really do, and I don't have any sugar to wake me up. Ooh, but you guys get what I mean. After 3 years, her family moved up there, and we're still together. But that's basically what I wanted to do in this book, was just have it take place, or have it take place for 3 months to represent, those 3 years, in short. What else? Oh. Ashley Nine Miller. She's basically a real person that is actually a friend of ours. It's a mutual friend, and she's one of Stacy's best friends. Ronan is pretty much based off of my friend Ruben, and Ruben, he has done welding in the past, and if you guys got a first draft of the book, I did actually say welding instead of blacksmithing. So that's where that came from. Wolf is a writer. I'm a writer. So, and Vi. Oh, her name. It does say, like, why her name is Vi. And that's pretty much the gist of it. Stacy is a musician, she's a violinist. So that's pretty much where the name came from. Vi is supposed to be short for violin, where Stacy plays the violin. So that's where her name comes from. What else? I guess that can be another thing, is that the moon. I do mention the moon a lot, pretty much calling it a goddess and all that. And Stacy is, she basically loves looking at the moon. So that's why the moon definitely plays a part in it. Wendell is based off of a real person. Armin sort of is based off of a real person. He's from the comic book cast, so there's that. There's really not much else. Let's see. I guess you could also say the statue, where I, you know, when I originally that last one of those last videos I did, where I was saying how the first feature I saw was her butt. That's not the first feature Wolf saw, but when he saw the statue originally, he observes it in a very artistic way. You know, he admires the features, which is a similarity to us. And I think that might be it. It might not be. But the last similarity I can say for right now. Oh, and Vi's family. Stacy is, in fact, a family of five. She does have three sisters, one brother, and her dad is a doctor or works in the hospital. I keep forgetting what he actually is, so I'm just gonna say a doctor. But he does work in the hospital. So there's also that other similarity. What else? There might be just a little bit more, but the last thing I will say is basically the feelings between Vi and the wolf. Those feelings, especially from Wolf, is definitely how I feel about my fiance. And I tried to make those feelings very strong with Wolf, where, you know, he's, and basically the personality as well, you know, Stacy's very outgoing. Wolf is very lonesome. You know, he's just more of a lonely person. He likes to be secluded. Where with Stacy, even though she's forced to be secluded, she definitely likes going out and actually having some fun. Actually, she's more in the middle, but you guys get what I mean. But that's pretty much most of the similarities. There might be a couple other similarities that I might be missing, but those are pretty much the gist of it. Pretty much. And, you know, there is one more at the end, but I'm not gonna say it because spoilers. But that's pretty much all the similarities I can list off the top of my head. So, yeah. I've been wanting to make a video like this for a while because that's what I told you guys is that the fox and the wolf is based off of our relationship, and I definitely wanted to tell you guys exactly what actually happened in our relationship, and I'm very happy to finally do that video for you guys. So, with that being said, I'm gonna end the video right here because the light has come upon us and I really want to go to sleep. So I'll see you guys next time. Bye.